In this video you will learn everything what you need to know to make a simple project in Altium Designer. You will learn how to create schematic symbols in schematic library, how to create footprints in footprint library, how to generate your PCB file, and how to generate outputs for PCB manufacturer and print some outputs into PDF. Let's start a new project. File, new project, PCB project, add schematic, add PCB, add schematic library, add PCB library, save project as. Now we are going to create schematic symbols. Place pin pressed up. Press space bar. You can change color, press tab. I will hide the pin names. Double click. R question mark. Okay. New LED, place pin, spacebar, hide the numbers. Spacebar, change grid to draw the small arrows, change the grid back. Double click. Tools connector. Place. I'll name them. Place connector body. Double click. And delete this. Now I'm going to create footprints, which are physical interpretation of the component. I always use component wizard. I know this number because I checked it before. This is component outline, what I'm doing now, what I'm moving. These are physical parts where the component will be soldered down. I can delete this. I'll create LED. The LED is similar to the resistor, it is SMD LED. I know pin number 1 is cathode in the schematic symbol. Control C, Control V. I'll just mark it like this. And now connector. It's good to always hit pin number 1 or plus sign, Control C, Control V. Now save the library, compile the library, go to schematic library, and we will add footprints, which we just have created. Go to the schematic, first save, then compile. We can now draw the schematic. Here select the library. Rotate, press spacebar. Now I will connect the components. I will name the nets. Press tab. You don't need to name all the nets. This is just for demonstration. I'll annotate the schematic, replace the question mark with a number. And I'll disable this, I never use it. Now we can import all our components into PCB. I'll change grid. Here are our components. Select. I'll move them. Rotate, press spacebar. Place them as you like. I will redefine board shape. Now we have to set few rules, few basic rules. Maximum width, track width used in the design. These parameters for vias. And here are some errors. It's this. I'll change it to 4. Okay, they are gone. Now we can draw the track. Press tab. We can define new size of the track, new width of the track. Connect all the pins. For demonstration, I'll use wire here. Double click on the wire and define new size of the wire. And also, again, for demonstration, I will place on the bottom layer, I'll place ground plane. Now I'll move this. We can add a text on the top layer. You can place it there and then change it here. On top overlay, or you can click on top overlay and then place the text. Now I go to mechanical one layer and draw board outline. Check if your PCB is okay. Go to design rule check and run it. Now check, you see there are no errors. The most important are unrouted nets, 0, clearance constraint, 0, short circuit, 0. We will now generate outputs. File, new, output job file. I'll delete this and make some changes here. I set scale 1:1 and black color only. Also, we need only for assembly drawing, we need only top overlay and board outline. We don't have the bottom overlay. I'll add one more with top and bottom layer. You can use this to print and make the PCB by yourself at home. Leave here only the top layer and mechanical board out with board outline. Now mirror, I will print the holes and everything. Okay, from the schematic you can have in color, It's nice. Delete this. Delete this. I'll leave Gerber files and configure them in millimeters and highest resolution. Drill file in highest resolution. From this I delete everything and leave only the bomb. I'll set usually this, as you can see here, and then now we can generate the files. The files will be located in project output directory. As you can see, it's now empty. You can generate each file separately, or you can generate one file with everything. This will be the first, second, third, fourth. As you see, schematic in color. This is our assembly drawing. This is the top layer with holes in the middle, bottom layer, and the bomb. This top, bottom layer, and the assembly drawing are in the scale 1:1, and you can use them to make your PCB at home. If you are going to send the PCB into manufacture, then go to generate files, select these two, generate the files, go to your output directory, and you see two directories in there. When you send these two directories to your PCB manufacturer, they will be able to make your PCB. Here, as you can see, is also the, there is located the file what we have printed with the schematic and everything in it. It was only very simple Altium Designer tutorial, and I would recommend you to go on my Well Done blog and read more posts about Altium Designer and look on more videos. I believe you will find them useful, and thank you for watching.